Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome to the very first episode of our brand new Southeast Asia Animal Pack Park Zoo Build, Speed Build, Zoom 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 kind of thing right here in Planet Zoo. We're going to build a zoo with all 8 of the brand new Southeast Asian animals and we're going to chuck a couple extras along the way. The gharial in particular, I've got a little bit of a habitat planned and maybe the Indian elephant along the way as well. We'll have to wait and see. For this first video, we're going to kind of, it's kind of a blast from the past a little bit. This is very similar to Temple Zoo, that zoo we worked on a long time ago when the South America pack first came out. This pack, the Southeast Asian pack, doesn't contain any new decorations or anything, so we do have to work with what we've already got. And when you look to Southeast Asia for inspiration, Cambodia, this is what particularly inspired this build, Cambodia, Vietnam, Thailand, etc., and you look at what people photograph there, it is predominantly ruins. Now, I'm sure there's lots of other beautiful things there, but ruins felt like a good place to start, and there's a nice little nod to our zoo from a while back, good old Temple Zoo. This zoo does not have a name quite yet. I do have to come up with one. If you have any suggestions, feel free to hit me up. It'd be nice if it was, you know, in a Southeast Asian language, or at least referenced it. But yeah, just building little staircase. I had this really nice image. I'll link my Pinterest down below if you want to follow and track what I've been doing, but I found this really nice image of a little ruin backed up against this waterfall, and I really wanted to build something vaguely similar, so that's kind of where I started, and it kind of spiraled out from there, and this build took like 5 hours or something ridiculous by the end. I may as well just prattle on for a little bit here. I'm going to spend a little while messing around with the faux rocks that we used back in the aquatic pack, but they look fake. And they are, you know, it's not the rock's fault. I'm sorry, rock, I don't blame you. But they do look fake. They don't look like real rocks. They lack the sort of the rough-hewn nature of real rock. So I ended up kind of putting them all in and colouring them, blah, blah, and then deleting them and using other rocks anyway. And I have a small complaint about that you'll see very soon, but we'll get there. So basically the idea is there's a staircase up on the left that takes you up to the walkway at the top, and there's going to be a waterfall falling down upon that. This is going to be like a little cave for our bear. Oddly enough, our bear, I have tried out, he can walk absolutely everywhere. The exhibit is jam-packed. It is full of stuff, it really is. There is no space on the ground. But the bear can walk absolutely everywhere. It's fantastic. I'm really excited about that. This is me, basically I was trying to recolor all the rock, but I didn't separate it into a different group. Look, I haven't played Planet Zoo in a while, alright? I hadn't put it in a different group. So I just kept moving it and trying to find where I'd like left like a little bit of the original rock. It was a... God, it was a pain. There it was, that cheeky little thing was hiding inside it. So what I like about this rock is we don't really have a dark rock in the game, and that's the only reason I was using the faux rock in the first place. It's because I wanted something dark, because it looks kind of wet, you know, has that kind of look to it. And then I put the mossy rock down, I was like, oh, okay, well, if it's a mossy rock. And then I was messing around with the tropical rock. There's a lot of humming and hawing and going back and forth at the start of this build. It's one of those builds that I wasn't happy with it until about 4 hours in. You know, right at the end, I've suddenly thought, oh, this looks okay, actually. But it took a long time to get there. Decided to go for the mossy rock, which is a rock I've kind of neglected. It must be said, I haven't used the mossy rock very often. But considering there's going to be a waterfall, and it's in the middle of the rainforest. Oh, I should mention, we're doing a boat tour. Now, we're not doing a boat tour for the entire park, but the first 3 or 4 habitats at the very least. I've got some really cool ideas that you guys are going to like for the clouded leopard in particular. I think is an awesome idea, and the gharial as well. That's all part of the boat tour, so is the proboscis monkey, proboscis. But past then, I've got less ideas, and it's going to turn into a more regular walking. It's not going to look too much like a zoo, it never does. But there are some light zoo elements going in, and there will be horror themes along the way, because of course there bloody well will be. But there wasn't really today. Actually, there was a little bit by the end. We'll talk about that later on. Anyways, it's a boat tour, basically. So the boat is going to come around this bend. You'll see I've put a bend there very specifically. And that's because I really liked this idea of you getting on the boat and you're in this dark... It was kind of inspired by the Amazon, even not on the Amazon. But, you know, you're in this dark rainforest going down the river and you turn the bend. You know, all you see is darkness and trees, and you turn the bend and this ancient ruin like bursts into view and there's sun bears crawling all over it. I thought that was a really cool image in my head. This kind of ruins emerging from nowhere, so that's why we've got the bend in there, and that's why there will eventually later on in this video be about 10,000 trees right there on that right hand side, just to make sure you can't see any of the habitat before you actually come around the corner. So anyways, I really wanted to integrate a waterfall. The start of this build felt really good. I had a really solid idea for what this bit was going to look like. This bit right here in front of us. I knew exactly what I wanted to do. Also, I really love how this looks, by the way. When you put like the rock just behind the water, I ended up going a little bit too hard on it, as I want to do. But it kind of gets this like misty look over the top of the rock. It's really nice, actually. It's really impressive looking. But yeah, the rest of the habitat was a bit more of a struggle, it must be said. A little bit. I should mention, we're going to do something a little different. Usually I would finish this video. We're going to do what we did in the aquatic park. Usually I would finish a time lapse and then I'd prattle on again for another 5-10 minutes and just look at the animals. We're going to do that, but I'm just going to film some nice dramatic shots of the habitat, basically. I'm not going to talk over it. It's going to be a nice view with me shutting up for once. You have to listen to me for... how long? 25 bloody minutes, folks! And this is at like 900% speed. So you have to listen to me for 25 minutes, but after that you can have 5 minutes of just enjoying the habitat. You know, that's going to be the deal going forward. And I'm going to try to make the time lapses a little bit quicker than that as well. Anyways, tree. Trees look cool. Strangler figs, always a good idea. They look great wrapped around the rock. They look great everywhere because they're the best trees in the game. I really wanted the water flow to feel quite natural here, so I was doing things like making sure it flowed down part of the staircase and that there were little ripple effects everywhere where the water was landing. It can be quite hard working on an exhibit of this. This is quite a small area, what we're working on here, and all the water effects are kind of absolutely bloody, like, ginormous. So, like, some of them don't look that big. You've got, like, the ripple in the middle, the in the middle, you know what I mean? And then you pause and you look at the outside, you can see it there, and there's just this massive ripple coming out. And that's fine, that's usually really good, but in circumstances where you're dealing with a very small surface area, it's kind of a pain in the ass. It'd be nice if we had even smaller ones for like little trickling waterfalls, and even bigger ones, actually. I'd like more variation. Yeah, just building up the temple. At this point, I was kind of making it up a little bit more of my own. This basic design was, you know, based on an existing temple. Architecture is not really my strong suit. I do like to base my architecture stuff on real existing areas. But about this point was where it all goes wrong, because I start making up my own stuff, basically. That's never a good sign. So there's another image I found of, again, this little Southeast Asian temple in, I believe this was Cambodia specifically. And it was just this really nice little image of a little staircase, and it went forward, and it's like a little shrine. It had these, it was all rock and stone, but then there's this like pop of highlighted colour, and I really wanted to integrate that as well. So we're going to do something a little bit like that. It had actually a really cool effect of this like jagged rock splayed all around the top, but... Alright, don't tell anyone I said this. The rocks in Planet Zoo, they kind of suck. I'm sorry. Prehistoric Kingdom has ruined me when it comes to rocks. Like, I loved Planet Zoo's rocks for so long, and now bloody Prehistoric Kingdom's ruined it for me. Because the rocks are just so good, and being able to scale them is so good. But I will say, coming back onto Planet Zoo and having all these amazing creative options has been really nice. You know, being able to do stuff like this. I could never do this on any other game on the planet, you know? Being able to do things like this is really cool. So yeah, I just wanted to build like a little shrine. A bit nondescript, really. Nothing specific about it. Want a little pop of colour to, you know, just make the exhibit a little more interesting to look at, basically. Just boom, red. And they'd walk up that shrine staircase and make an offering and, you know, all that kind of jazz. This is where I started to struggle. Because this exhibit clearly is not big enough for several bears. And some bears like my favourite animal in the pack, so there had to be several bears, of course. And I just wasn't sure what to do with this whole left-hand side. The right-hand side is going to be, of course, blocked off. But the left was a problem for a very, very long time. I think I figured it out, and I think it ends up looking pretty cool, but it took some hard work. So we're gonna lay down some, the idea as it always is, a little bit, that, you know, this is an ancient temple, it's been overgrown a little bit, it's been abandoned, it's been left behind, the bears have taken it over. I like to think, oh no, it is, it used to be a shrine to the bears in particular. You know, you'd imagine there's a civilization living in the area, and the sun bear represents, I don't know, I'm sure the sun bear does represent some good stuff, but it's a sun bear, right? It represents the sun, like a good harvest and good weather and good times. That's what the sun bear is. So this is like a little shrine to the sun bear. So they built it into the cave, into the rock, so the sun bear could actually live within the shrine, and they could also leave food offerings and stuff for the bear. What I'm saying all this is to justify the fact that I'm going to put many bear statues all over the bloody place, because I thought they looked cool. We have tons of new statues available to us of several animals, because the campaign and the timed challenges now reward statues. And one of those is a bear. Now, it's not a sun bear, technically. I think it's a grizzly bear, but that's neither here nor bear. Eh? Eh? It's the funniest thing I've ever said. I also say I have a deep love for the... Because I don't want to rag on Planet Zoo. I love Planet Zoo. I have a deep love for the chisel tool. Planet Zoo's chisel tool is so good. So very good. So anyways, this was me kind of... I needed something on this left-hand side. And I wasn't really sure what it was going to be. And it became a walkway. And for a long time, it was a walkway to nothing. I was just trying to figure out, what am I doing here? What am I doing? How am I going to piece this together? Do I want lots of gold? I'm not really a flashy kind of guy. We don't want lots of gold. Just a little bit. A little bit. And I just started to build, basically, and hoped that it would eventually look okay. And it does. It does. Not my best work. Not my worst work. I've had some bad work out there. I'm very excited for the future builds. I've got some really cool ideas for this park. Not all the ideas are taken, though. You know, if you want to leave suggestions for, say, the Babirusa, I've got a faint idea, but I've not committed to it. I was considering doing something based on Anaconda, because that takes place in the rainforest, and there's a scene at the end of Anaconda when they're in like this, I think it's an oil rig actually, but I don't quite remember. This is the platform, by the way. And I wanted to build the oil rig from Anaconda, basically. God, it might not even be an oil rig, but it's like an abandoned building in the rainforest, and it looks cool. I thought that'd be cool for the Babirusa. Don't know what's got to do with Anaconda, but just Babirusa, Anaconda, it kind of rhymes. So I decided this was going to be a vault of some description, I think, is what it kind of ended up being. It's kind of like got this like long red carpet kind of vibe to it, and it enters into the building into like this hidden little cove section. We're going to load that up with gold and the golden bear later on. So that's kind of, I had to justify somehow filling in this left hand part of the exhibit and give our bears some space. And it's kind of what we ended up doing, basically. I will say, no, Planet Zoo's rocks don't suck. I was being too harsh. The problem is you can't scale them, and I've been spoiled by the ability to scale. I had to sneeze. So, right, yes, yeah, so just adding more detail now, just, you know, staggering the rocks into the landscape, building it up, trying to make it look a little bit more natural, all that usual kind of jazz, really. Because you can't have one area loaded with mossy rock and then have no rock anywhere else. That looks silly. I also was trying to keep the water separate. You'll see I'm able to select the water individually now, which is really, really cool. That's a new part of the update. And you can change colouring, you can change transparency. So my theory for this was, and why I've done it the way I have, is that the pool furthest to the back left, that one over in the top left you can see there, would be the dirtiest, because there's no free-flowing water there, it's very stagnant. The closer one would be a little cleaner, and then the one where the water actually flows in from the waterfall would be the cleanest one, because there's churning water, and that tends to keep things at least moderately cleaner, right? Because the water flows and carries dirt with it elsewhere. So, you know, it's nice. It's a cool option that we can do this now, that we can choose individual colours. We can make bright pink lakes and stuff like that. You can do some pretty crazy stuff. You can also do some pretty crazy stuff with the screens. You'll see in the actual video. I've got some pretty cool ideas for that. I'll show you that. I'm going to do like a mini video on the screens tomorrow. I've got a very cool idea that I want to show you guys, though. It's a very cool idea. Just saying, it's a very cool idea. Anyways, yeah. So there's not much to talk about when I'm just staggering rocks everywhere. I think you've all watched me put down rocks about 5,000 times by now. I feel like it's what I do for a living. I don't talk for YouTube, I don't play video games or design parks or anything else, you know, cover mod spotlights or anything else for a living. I put rocks down in. That is literally my job. But the water feature is fantastic. There I could have that kind of natural blue colouring, but a little bit dirtier. It's a little bit, it's not totally clean, because why would it be? And now it's time for a little bit of foliage work. I break up some sight lines, get some interesting shadows in there. Just generally speaking, make the habitat a little bit more interesting to look at. it doesn't, the habitat didn't have like a such a strong theme that I felt like I always knew what I was doing. It felt kind of freeform in a lot of ways. I mean, abandoned temple to praise the sun bears sounds like quite a strong theme that I think about it, but yeah, you know, by my standards it's kind of weak, so I'll come up with more of a story. I've got like something brewing in the back of my mind, but I feel like I always go to the same well when it comes to temples, so it's more rocks. It's just rocks and foliage. Custard apples, sink those into the ground, they make really nice, you know, bushes and ground texture as per usual. Some little baby trees, one big stinky flower. Can't have too many big stinky flowers, of course. I just wanted, again, for it to feel overgrown and lush and vibrant and living. I love these things, by the way, the hyacinths. The water hyacinths, you get lots of, like, the little green ones. And for some reason, I decided they grow around the ruins. It's nice to have a little story. Doesn't have to make sense. Remember, no realism, just vibes. And the vibe is the hyacinths grow around the ruins, okay? That's what they do. They just deal with it, alright? So, we get to use those whenever there's ruins in the water. It's not about being hyper-realistic. Or maybe it is for some people, I'm sure it is. But for me, it's about just telling a consistent story with your foliage, with your rocks, with everything. It's about telling... Yeah, it's about telling a story, basically. Those hyacinths on the left shouldn't be there. I'll have to add some ruins there to justify them. But they look really nice. I've never used them before. It's cool. I'm a little apprehensive about some parts of this build later on, just because we didn't get a decoration pack. Anyway, says the boat tour. So the boat's going to wrap around, as you say, you won't be able to see anything then. The ruins. Now, the problem, of course, with this is that I do have to put trees absolutely bloody everywhere. Here and here and here and here. Like, the whole area needs to be surrounded in foliage, because it has to feel like a dense, kind of spooky jungle. That's what we go for. You know, we like our spookiness. And it must be said, the new audio tools and the new billboards, which we can put videos in and, you know, we can put scary music in the game and stuff, is going to make the horror aspect of this game very cool. It's not going to be this one. This one takes inspiration from lots of beautiful places in Southeast Asia. It's not all horror themed, I promise. There's one in particular, the Binturong habitat later on is going to be based on this amazing lotus farm that I saw a picture of that I want to recreate as best I can. Really excited about that one. There's a little bear, adorable. What was I saying? But we're going to build a horror park, like just full on, because I've got video, I can put videos into the game, I can put audio into the game. How could I resist building a horror park? It's going to be very cool, I'm very excited. Or Jurassic Park park, both are very viable options. Anyways, putting in some stuff for the bear here. Usually I would be, I don't know why I decided to make it look a little bit like an exhibit. I don't know, it's kind of a weird mesh between what I would usually do, where it doesn't look anything like an exhibit. But then we have some exhibit stuff, so that's new hammock enrichment there at the back. And I put more stone down. It looks nice though, doesn't it? I don't know where this happened. It feels like 5 minutes ago, it didn't look like anything, and suddenly, oh, it looks like a habitat now. Alright, cool. There's our hyacinths near the ruins. Gotta be near the root. There's the rules, folks. Them's the rules. I don't like empty space. I want each little segment of the floor to tell an individual story about what was there in the past, you know? And I feel like when it's just bare ground, it just doesn't do that. And maybe that's more less realistic, and maybe it ends up looking cluttered and stuff, but it's just how I don't know, it just excites me more, I think. What was I doing? Oh yeah, the bear. I ended up putting like a climbing frame in. Ah, that, yeah. I had a slight panic here. I was thinking, how the hell is the keeper going to get in? Because there is a slight problem that you still need a keeper no matter what in Planet Zoo. Which brings me to another thing. Not a complaint, but I only just thought about this. This is sandbox mode. Can we please have a thing that stops your animals from wanting to escape? Like, I shouldn't have to have certain heights of fence and stuff like that in sandbox mode. And you'll see why it's a problem, because I have to figure out how to keep the bloody bear contained when there's a river tour moving right through its habitat. And it can be done, but it's not easy, folks. It's really not easy. And at this point in time, I'm keeping the water out so I can work on it slowly and keep the bloody thing in. It feels like the kind of thing that on a sandbox mode, which the point is limitless creativity, right? That's what sandbox is about. It feels like the kind of thing we should be able to do. And I will say, I've never thought to ask for that before, but it'd be nice. So maybe that's something they can integrate in the future. I will hopefully message someone from Frontier. But you can see the problem there. So what we do, and I did this in the past, if you think back to My Pen Rye, which was the first build we ever did when Planet Zoo actually came out after the beta that we played here on the channel. And we had a boat tour with the crocodiles, I believe. And what I did was staggered rocks near the actual boat bit, and that kind of blocked the crocodile in. I've got no idea if there's another way to do this, but that was the only way I could think of. So we do have a climbing frame, because I think it kind of works, and I thought if our justification is, and there's a golden bear, and there's the bronze bear, and the silver bear, and there's another golden bear, and there's a little stone bear, if the justification is that this was a temple to praise and, you know, give favour to the sun bear, it would make sense that they would design things that they know the sun bear likes. You know, we can justify zoo items in our not super zooey looking build. And, you know, we give it some rock at the base and stuff like that, as you'll see right here. There we go. Attach some string to it and stuff. Just little things to make it feel a little bit more handcrafted and hand-built and a little bit more thematically in time with everything else going on in the surrounding area. And then trees. As per usual, I will advise people do this. Not necessarily to this extent, but if you want your parks to look better, just put a ring of trees and foliage and stuff on the outside, or just make a big ass mountain and drag it around the outside. The huge distance of these maps makes parks look worse than they are. Just saying, top tip. That I say all the time, so it's probably not that necessary anymore. You'll see I'm fairly constantly removing the water and putting it back in. I am incredibly paranoid, I'm not gonna lie, because the water sometimes in this game is a little bit finicky and it will not let you put it back in, so I have to keep trying it. I had a moment just like that a little bit later on in the video, but fortunately I figured out how to fix it. Just putting some ruins into the woods here, nothing too specific, I'm just grabbing ruins that we've already made kind of thing and sticking them in there, just so there's a little bit of a hint of what's to come, you know, just... My headset just turned off randomly. You're taking this boat tour around through this river, and there's like a little, you know, a little hint of a rune there, a little hint of rune there. Maybe you catch a flash of a torch firing off in the distance. Maybe you hear, you know, some drums or the call of a bear or something. You're just little tropical rune vibes, basically. That's all. That's all I've got. It's always the same thing. So you should be used to it by now. It's nice to be able to go back. Our next habitat is actually very inspired by My Pen Rye, the first habitat we did in My Pen Rye. So if you remember that one, you'll have a rough idea of what to expect. Lilies. What are they called? Lotus. Good, because we need lotuses for our future habitat. I've got so many good ideas for this park. It's crazy. My only concern is buildings. Like, I don't have, like, you know, like the docks from the aquatic bag and stuff like that. I don't have that idea in my head quite yet. But we'll get there. I need to find some vibes from a Southeast Asian horror film. I have to do some research into Southeast Asian horror films. Anyways. Let's point some foliage in. So these are the billboards. And the billboards are large. And this is like one of the smaller ones, but it's still very large. But I really liked the idea, and again, this is making it feel a little bit more like an actual zoo. Oh, we must be nearly done. Yeah. Oh, so sad. To make it feel a little bit more like an actual zoo, but I'm going to build advertisements for each distinct area of the zoo. And it's an opportunity for me to flex my skills in Photoshop. It's one of the few things I'm good at in life. So, for the purposes of this video in a little bit, you are going to have... It's like a temporary sun bear educational board. I just don't have the time to rig it up quite yet. I'm going to change the educational idea, though. I don't like it as much. Taking my vibes from... I've said vibes far too many times. I've not said thematic once, but I've said vibes like five times. But taking my inspiration from things like Universal Studios, or just theme parks in general, where you would enter a new area and you have like a big sign saying, "You are now entering Carnival Cove or Pirate Paradise or Billy Bob's Junction." I don't know who Billy Bob is or why he needs an entire junction to himself, but he does, okay? This was me panicking about not being able to refill the river. So I thought, oh, maybe it's a sign. It's not. It's that path right there. So the path can't be there. As soon as the path is gone, it's fine. As you'll see, there we go. So the path is bad and the path will not be added until later on, which means we can't try out the actual boat. Well, we could. We just couldn't refill the river. Yeah, we can try out the boat. Maybe because there's no exit, though. Anyways, so the point is to have a sign like that. So I'm going to build a sign in Photoshop that says, "You are now entering... the Temple of the Sun Bear or something. And my... Also, there's a jeep. Because there's always a jeep whenever I build in the rainforest. There has to be a jeep. Because some explorer came by, seeking the fabled lost treasure of the Sun Bear. And then he got eaten by the bear, obviously. Because that's how these things always work. It's science. You can't denounce science. Anyways... So, like, kind of like you imagine, like, World of Warcraft logos for Burning Crusade and stuff. I've got that kind of idea in my head where each area is going to have welcome to... dot dot dot, and they're going to build a unique logo for each exhibit. That'll be the Temple of the Sun Bear, the, you know, Binturong Lotus Farm, stuff like that. Just little names. I'm going to build, like, a little logo, and it'll kind of have a feeling of progression throughout the entire park, and maybe we'll even put some custom music in and stuff like that. We're going to have fun with it. Fun is fun. Done. Right, there you go. So that is a nice little final look, but of course I will show you it in game. I did go back and do some lighting work, nothing too excessive this time, just a little bit, but we'll get some nighttime shots as well. Yeah, fairly chill to, I say fairly chill to kick things off, but it took 5 hours. So it wasn't chill at all. It took bloody ages. Anyways, that's enough word talking from me. I'll give you that little tour in game now. Thank you so much for joining me. Stick around for that in a second, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you.
Reaching out.